Hello everyone, welcome to my course. My name is Marfa Yasmin. I am your instructor for this course. In this lecture, I am going to cover about basics of Node.js. Why Node.js? A common task for a web server can be to open a file on the server and return the content to the client. Here is how PHP or ASP handles a file request. Sends the task to the computer's file system. Waits while the file system opens and reads the file. Returns the content to the client. Ready to handle the next request. What is Node.js? Node.js is an open source, cross-platform JavaScript runtime environment for executing JavaScript code server side. It enables JavaScript to be used for server-side scripting and runs script server-side to produce dynamic web page content before the page is sent to the user's web browser. Node.js is a platform built on Chrome JavaScript runtime for building fast and scalable network applications. No buffering. Node.js applications never buffer any data. These applications simply output the data in chunks. License. Node.js is released under the MIT license. Let's say the example. Here you can look var http equal to require, then http dot create server, then res dot end hello world. Who uses node.js? Following is the link on GitHub wiki containing an exhaustive list of projects, applications and companies which are using node.js. This list includes eBay, General Electric, GoDaddy, Microsoft, PayPal, Uber, Wikipins, Yahoo, and Yammer to name a few. projects, applications and companies using Node. See the examples. Create a server object, then http.createServer, then res.returnHey, next res.end. Running in the command line interface. What is a node.js file? Node.js files contain tasks that will be executed on certain events. A typical event is someone trying to access a port on the server. Node.js files must be initiated on the server before having any effect. Node.js files have extension .js. See another example. When to use Node.js? Node.js is best for uses in streaming or event-based real-time applications like chat applications, game servers, fast and high-performance servers that need to process thousands of requests at a time, then this is an ideal framework. Good for collaborative environment. This is good for environments which manage documents. In a document management environment, you will have multiple people who post their documents and do constant changes by checking out and checking in documents. So Node.js is good for this environment because the event loop is Node.js can be triggered whenever documents are changed in a document managed environment. Advertisement servers. Again, here you could have thousands of requests to pull advertisements from the central server, and Node.js can be an ideal framework to handle this. Streaming servers. Another ideal scenario to use Node is for multimedia streaming servers, wherein clients have requests to pull different multimedia contents from this server. That is all for this lecture. Thanks for watching. Hi everyone, welcome to my course. In the last lecture, I was covered about basics of Node.js. In the present lecture, I am going to learn about modules and file system. Node.js module. Module in Node.js is a simple or complex functionality organized in single or multiple JavaScript files, which can be reused throughout the Node.js application. Each module in Node.js has its own context, so it cannot interfere with other modules or pollute global scope. Also, each module can be placed in a separate .js file under a separate folder. Node.js implements Common JS Modules Standard. Common JS is a group of volunteers who define JavaScript standards for web server, desktop, and console application. Third-party modules. Node.js core modules. Node.js is a lightweight framework. The core modules include bare minimum functionalities of Node.js. These core modules are compiled into its binary distribution and load automatically when Node.js process starts. However, you need to import the core module first in order to use it in your application. See the example. First, show var event equal to require, then var event emitter. Next, assign the event handler to an event, then fire the scrim event. Require are used to consume modules. It allows you to include modules in your programs. You can add built-in core Node.js modules, community-based modules, and local modules. Built-in modules. Exports is an alias of module.py export. Consequently, whatever you assign to exports is also available on module.exports. However, if you assign something directly to exports, then you lost the shortcut to module.exports. Imports. Starting with version 8.5.0 plus, Node.js supports ES modules natively with a feature flag and a new file extension star.mjs. Node.js file system. Node.js includes FS module to access physical file system. The FS module is responsible for all the asynchronous or synchronous file /o operations. Let us see some of the common /o operations using FS module. Reading file. Use fs.readfile method to read the physical file asynchronously. Callback. A function with two parameters, r and fd. This will get called when write operation complete. See look at the exports equal to hello world. When you install Node, it comes with many built-in modules. Node comes with batteries included. Some of the most used core modules are FS, allows you to manipulate files and directories, path, utilities to work with files and directories path, HTTP, create HTTP servers and clients for web development, URL, utilities for parsing URLs and extracting elements from it. Exports. The exports keyword gives you the chance to export your objects and methods. Let's see the another example. Open file. Alternatively, you can open a file for reading or writing using fs.open method. That's all for my lecture. Thanks for watching. In the last lecture, I was explained about modules and file system. In the present lecture, I am going to cover about NPM in Node.js. Command line utility to install Node.js packages, do version management and dependency management of Node.js packages. NPM comes bundled with Node.js installables after v0.6.3 version. To verify the same, open console and type the command global versus local installation. By default, NPM installs any dependency in the local mode. Here, local mode refers to the package installation in node modules directory lying in the folder where node application is present. Locally deployed packages are accessible via require method. For example, when we installed express module, it created node modules directory in the current directory where it installed the express module. And in the present lecture, I am going to cover about NPM in node.js. Node package manager provides two main functionalities: online repositories for node.js packages / modules, which are searchable on search.nodejs.org. See the example. You can show var uc equal to require rs dot write head and content type. Next, rs dot written uc hello world. Alternatively, you can use npm ls command to list down all the locally installed modules. Globally installed packages or dependencies are stored in system directory. Such dependencies can be used in CLI function of any node.js but cannot be imported using require in node application directly. Now let us try installing the at the time of writing this article NPM has 580096 registered packages. The average rate of growth of this number is 291 per day, which outraces every other package registry. NPM is open source. The top NPM packages in the decreasing order are Lodash, Asins, React, Request, Express, Repository. Repository type and URL of the package. Main entry point of the package keywords creating a module requires package JSON to be generated. Let us generate package.json using npm, which will generate the basic skeleton of the package.json. See another example. Here is http dot create server function res dpt and hello world dot listen. Creating a node project. To create a node project, npm in it is used in the folder in which user want to create project. The npm command line will ask a number of questions like name, license, scripts, description, author, keywords, version, main file, etc. After npm is done creating the project, a package.json file will be visible in project folder as a proof that the project has been initialized. So that is all for my lecture. Thanks for watching. Hi everyone, welcome to my course. In the last lecture I was covered about npm in node.js. In the last lecture, I am going to cover about events. Node.js events. According to the official documentation of Node.js, it is an asynchronous event driven JavaScript runtime. Node.js has an event-driven architecture which can perform asynchronous tasks. Node.js has an events module which emits named events that can cause corresponding functions or callbacks to be called. Functions listen or subscribe to a particular event to occur, and when that event triggers, all the callbacks subscribed to that event are fired one by one in order to which they were registered. The event emitter class. All objects that emit events are instances of the event emitter class. The event can be emitted or listened to an event with the help of event emitter. Listening events. Before emits any event, it must register functions to listen to the events. See the example. First, you can show constant event emitter equal to require. Then, class my emitter extends. Next, constant my emitter equal to new my emitter. Last my emitter dot emit. Event emitter dot on and event emitter dot add listener are pretty much similar. It adds the listener at the end of the listeners array for the specified event. Multiple calls to the same event and listener will add the listener multiple times and correspondingly fire multiple times. Both functions return emitter, so calls can be chained. Event emitter dot ons fires at most once for a particular event and will be removed from listeners array after it has listened once. Returns emitter so calls can be chained. Events module. Node.js has a built-in module called Events, where you can create, fire, and listen for your own events. To include the built-in events module, use the require method. In addition, all event properties and methods are an instance of an event emitter object. Let's create an example. See the event emitter equal to add listener. Then event emitter dot on. Finally event emitter dot ons. The event emitter object. You can assign event handlers to your own events with the event emitter object. To fire an event, use the emit method emitter.once. Adds a callback function that is called when an event is emitted for the first time after registering this. This callback is only going to be called once, never again. Emitter dot prepend listener. When you add a listener using on or add listener, it is added last in the queue of listeners and called last. Using prepend listener, it is added and called before other listeners. Emitter dot remove listener. Remove a specific listener. You can do this by saving the callback function to a variable when added, so you can reference it later. See example. That is importing events, where constant event emitter equal to require. Then initializing event emitter instance. Next, triggering my event. Emitting events. Every event is named event in Node.js. We can trigger an event by emit function. We can pass an arbitrary set of arguments to the listener functions. Removing listener. The event emitter dot remove listener takes two argument event and listener and removes that listener from the listeners array that is subscribed to that event. While event emitter dot remove all listeners removes all the listeners from the array which are subscribed to the mentioned event. Let's look at the example. That's all for my lecture. Thanks for watching. Hi there, welcome to my course. In the last lecture I was explained about event, and in the present lecture I am going to cover about file uploading and emails. The formidable module. There is a very good module for working with file uploads called formidable. The formidable module can be downloaded and installed using npm. After you have downloaded the formidable module, you can include the module in any application. Upload files. Now you are ready to make a web page in node.js that lets the user upload files to your computer. Create an upload form. Node mailer features. Create a node.js file that writes an HTML form with an upload file field. Let's see an example. First, the uploaded file. Include the formidable module to be able to parse the uploaded file once it reaches the server. Use the username and password from your selected email provider to send an email. This example will show you how to use your Gmail account to send an email. Multiple receivers. To send an email to more than one receiver, add them to the to property of the mail options object, separated by commas. See example. key description dist or storage the where to store the files file filter function to control which files are accepted, limits of the uploaded data, preserve path, keep the full path of files instead of just the base name. Following is the snippet where you can see storage is defined. In multer.disk storage, we have to set the file storage destination. Each file contains the information. Key description, node field name. Field name is specified in the form. Original name of the file on the user's computer. Encoding type of the file. MIMI type of the file. Size of the file in bytes. Destination, the folder to which the file has been saved. Disk storage, file name, the name of the file within the destination disk storage path, the full path to the uploaded file disk storage buffer, a buffer of the entire file memory storage. That is all for my lecture. Thanks for watching.